people who will be tuning in later can still watch the beginning of the discussion. So, reading. By the way, in the IELTS, we have divided the exam into two sections. So we have the written component, which I will be explaining deeply later. And we have the one-on-one interview, right? So the one-on-one interview is otherwise known as your speaking exam. So we will be talking about the speaking test sometime in the future. So we will be focusing more on the written component, particularly today, reading, tomorrow, writing. So listening is the first part of your written component. So when I say listening, listening is the easiest test in the IELTS. Whether you underwent review programs or not, whether you attended lectures or not, you are guaranteed to get a 7 in the listening exam. How? Well, the data shows us that the national average band score of Filipino test takers is 7 for listening. The chances are, if you go to, let's say, Greenlights Home Depot, yung mga kuya dyan, kuya, hindi ka nga, pag-taking kita ng IELTS, chances are makaka-7 yun sa listening, even without preparation. Yes? So, it is easy to get a band 7. It is achievable to exceed band 7, 7.5. You can get an 8. By the way, our branch performance as a whole for 2023 is 8 for listening. Sabihin, kung sudyante ka ng 9er, chances are makakuha ka ng 8 sa listening, which I will explain how to do it. Okay? So, reading. Yan. Reading is the second test. So after listening, there will be no breaks given in between. You have to jump to reading right after. And reading is the part where you get to feel the urge to pee. Kasi medyo maginaw, 40 minutes yung listening, tapos ang alahati kasi naiihi ka na. No? So medyo uncomfortable ka na, medyo uneasy ka na. That's why we actually suggest, we actually recommend, highly recommend that you undergo familiarization of the text. You undergo an experience that is closely similar to the actual thing. And that is why we do mock exams. Okay? So now, let me explain the concept of mock exams to you. Mock exams are simulations of the written subtest. Listening, reading, writing, respectively. So we do it the same way as how you're expected to do it in the actual event of you taking the test. And the good news is, Niner, just right beside this wall, di ko nakakatokan yung simile exam. And then you may yung process ko. This is testing center. We conduct exams Friday, Saturday, Sunday. For Michigan English test, Sunday and Monday. No? So that's another examination that we also cater here in the branch. And we open this area, this testing center, beside this wall, right? Through this wall. We open this for our students for free, 2 times a week. Every Tuesday, every Friday, except today, and may exam. Natural, sino unahin namin? Yung exam o kayo? Palingan na mukha niyo, no? Right, charot lang. So, kaya po, in-adjust namin kahapon. So, we do adjustments. Para din sa inyo. Okay po? Alright. So, sir, again, what's the point of taking mock? Is it just for familiarization na ito yung mouse, ito yung PC, kung saan ako mag-take ng exam? No. Actually, we are going to let you experience the actual examination. Yung pa, yung pa. Na, ayun yung panood. Yung exam, yung April 2024. Exam last week. Para, teka, nag-practice ako. Ano ko lang, syente. Butya, nakapahit po ba tayo naman? Ano nga yung sarili mo? Malapit ba sa realidad? Na final exam ka, soon, makukuha mo yung target balance score mo. Oo, hindi. Hindi. Diba? Target mo 7, nakuha mo 5.5. So, ano ibig sabihin nun? You have to push harder next time. Kasi, we always get this from our students na, sir, first, did my mock exam in this rank? I got 4. I took my test. How long did it take that person to reach this level of consistently getting an 8 from getting 4 initially? About 2 to 3 months. That's why when someone asks me healthy duration of preparation, no less than 2 months. Okay? It's 2 months. This will enable you to attend major lectures including reading. It will enable you to undergo several practices, 5 to 10 at least. So kung ilang linggo meron sa dalawang buwan, 8. Isang beses isang linggo, naka-8 ang practice. Kung sasagarin mo, 2 beses, 15 beses na mga kapag mo. So plenty of time for you to develop. Plenty of time for you to grow. Okay? Now, the reason why reading is becoming an alarming exam lately is the fact that quite recently, I have noticed that some of the students sending me thank you messages, which in response, I will be sending them congratulatory messages in return. They will be telling me, sir, here are my scores. 8 listening, as expected. 7 speaking, that's great. Everyone can get that. Writing of 7, wow. It's actually an impressive feat. Because in the past, people would need to take the exam multiple times just to get a bad 7 in writing. And sir, my reading is 5.5. Pag magpapakita sa akin, sasampalin kita sa pag-isa. Huh? Pakapagod lang ako kakadaldan sa lecture, tapos 5.5 na reading mo. That's why it's becoming quite an alarming scene from me. This reading is supposed to be an exam that is much, much easier than writing. Because if you're going to take a look at the difference. Reading, you just have to answer questions, right? Where in writing, you have to answer question in an essay format. And your essay will be judged according to several factors. Ito kung A ang sagot, B ang sagot mo, de mali. C ang sagot mo, tama. Eh yung essay, paliwanag. Diba? Grammar, vocabulary, coherence and cohesion, the conjunctions that you will use. So many things, so many factors that will play in the assessment of writing. Whereas in reading, it's whether your answer is right or wrong. There's justification. How come that lately, I am seeing quite a lot of people, and when I say a lot, it's a lot, getting a score lower than 6 in reading, but higher than 6 in writing. So we call this the dark force of the test. Because you might not understand how difficult the situation you're in when it comes to reading unless you experience it. So that's what we're trying to avoid in the in our preparation. We want to remove the element of surprise. So you have to be able to adapt early on so that regardless of whatever difficulty your reading test is on, you'll be able to adjust to it during your test. So you will not be affected negatively by it. Okay? So reading. There's so many things I will be discussing this morning. So prepare kayo, na? Okay? So some people would like to take screenshots or take photos of the slide. As I've mentioned in the beginning of my discussion, everything that you will see from the first to the whatever number slide this presentation has, I'll be giving it to you for free in PDF form. Why PDF? Accessible by iOS, Android, and Windows devices. Okay, questions so far? So the first thing you need to know about reading is it's difficult. That's it. You have to accept the fact. It will not get easier for you. It's always going to be difficult. So this expectation of how difficult reading is, it could be at this difficulty level back. So expect the worst of the worst when it comes to reading. So don't want to be caught off guard by it. Okay? So as I've mentioned, this is the second test in the written component of the exam. So I will be referring to your listening, reading, writing as written component. Sometimes I will be referring to it as LRW, but I shall stick with the written component. Pag sabing written component, silang tatlo. Okay? Disregarding the speaking test. Those three. So if you book your test kasi, let's say, ayan, book sila ng September 27, the exam. Expected mo, listening mo alas 9, reading mo 9:30, writing mo 10:30, tapos ka ng 11:30. Okay, pag yun yung written component, the overall listening, reading, writing sa tests. So si speaking, pwede may speaking mamayang hapon, pwede may speaking sila bukas. So it's 1 to 2 days before, during, or after the written component. So it's a separate exam to speaking. So, as I've mentioned, there are no breaks given in between subtests. Listening, proceed to reading right after, writing comes next without any breaks whatsoever. Sir, what if I really have to pee? Diba? It's a natural urge. Well, you will be going to the toilet, okay? The test invigilator will be instructing you. And then the time that you will be spending on the toilet will be taken off from the time of your exam. Ibig sabihin, yung timer ng test, gumagana siya habang ikaw ay busy na nagsisipar. Kaya during the test, I will always remind my students not to drink too much caffeinated beverages. I know, even myself. I couldn't live without my daily dose of caffeine. But try to minimize it. Huwag naman tatlong tasa. Kasi mag-iihi ka talaga dun. Because coffee is a known diuretic. Huwag din masyadong matcha or masoda. Kasi nga mag-iihi ka dun. You're actually allowed to bring water with you. So if you will be booking your test, they will be sending you an email that contains everything you need to know during your exam. Like what to do, what not to do, what to bring, what not to bring. Kasi pag dinala mo yung mga di dapat dala, hindi ka rin yung exam. No, may dala kang patali, may dala kang baril. No, nalaksa ka doon sa exam. Ayan. Ano pa? Pati yung bottled water, bawal po kasi yung may label. So tatanggalin mo siya. You know why? Bakit may ganong rule? Medyo tight yung security. Kasi, ang examiners ay mga foreigners. And most of them are from British descent. So, from the UK sila karamihan. Yung mga foreigner na examiners po dito. So, in the past, na meron lang tayong pen and paper-based exam, wala pa tayong computer-based test like what we are currently enjoying right now. Papasok lalabas ang mga tao without them knowing kung ang dalaban nilang liquid ay paggawa ng bomba. Diba? Kasi sa ganun, may mga maglilibot na people from Europe, punta sila to Mindanao, ikidnapin sila mga abo sa'yo, pupugutan sila ng ulo. So, natatakot sila. Takot actually sila sa mga Pilipino. Sa ibang bansa, walang ganyan rule. E ako man, syempre kayo, makikita ko, itura nyo na yan. Hindi talaga naman. Security, ano? Check nyo mabuti, ano? Okay? Mga mukha kayo hindi katiwa-tiwala, eh. So, yan. If you're going to take the pen and paper-based test, though, which is still available in provincial exams, for provincial exams area,
excuse me, na ba yan?
And even in Manila. Dito po sa Kabanatuan, if I'm not mistaken, 3 times a year lang. So, 3 times a year for British Council. Tuwing Valentine's Day at saka All Saints Day palaging meron. Schedule. No? And then, si IDP, tatlong beses din sa isang taon. So, in total, you have 6 examination dates for 2024 calendar in Kabanatuan. In Pampanga, mas madalas, monthly ang exam nila. Sa Manila, if I'm not mistaken, 3 times a week ang kanilang date for pen and paper based exam. Pero dito po kay computer based, which is much more common, sa Manila, every day, kung gusto mo linggo ka mag-exam, may problema. Even sa amin, meron kaming Sunday na exam. So, Friday, Saturday, Sunday po, laging schedule na open for Kabanatuan Test Center. Tanong po? So for pen and paper based exam, they will provide you with the material. There's no need for you to bring pencils, erasers, whatsoever. But again, ha, just for the sake of being prepared, magtala ka na rin, just to be sure. Okay? Tala ka na rin isang notes. So meron po ba ditong interested mag-take yun? Pen and paper based exam? So what's the difference anyway? So I'll be explaining it to you later. What is the difference between the pen and paper based exam and the computer based exam with the way how you will be taking it? But the first difference you have to understand is that the pen and paper based examination results will be out after 2 weeks. Agad, imagine mo, diba, magtitake na exam bukas, tapos 2 weeks pa bago lumabas yung result. Pero makatulog. Unang linggo pa lang, ay bago parang si Poena sa Kuku Panda, Master Shifu, yung nasa paligid. Sabi ng nanay niya, anak, kumain ka naman ba? Huh? Tagal eh, tagal lang agon eh. Only for ito noon, ano kung bagsak pa na, diba? Bansa na. Pero yun, kapag computer-based, 48 hours. The results, the initial results po, yung soft copy, meron na siya through email. And then yung hard copy niya, papadala niya sa'yo doon sa mailing address mo after 2 weeks pa din. Okay, but at least alam mo na. Meron ka ng notification. Okay, pumasa. Pwede na kayo mag-inuman. Pwede na kayo mag-subview. Questions po? Wala? Wala po? Seryoso niyo naman. Dapat lang. Mahirap to. Alright. So if you will be taking the pen and paper based tests, the listening and reading answer sheets are very identical. And actually, they share the same page, huh? So you need to be extra careful on the listening exam to make sure na hindi niya mapupunit, masisira yung reading answer sheet mo. So ganito po ang appearance niya. Ay, wala pala akong sample. Pero kulay orange po yung sheet of paper. 1 to 20 items on the left, 21 to 40 items on the right side of your answer sheet. So, may I see the hands of people who will take the academic module? Academic? The only, come on guys, don't be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 po, ano? 5, only 5 candidates will take the academic module. What about the GT? May I see the hands of GT? Alright, so GT, okay, GT, your exam is easier. That's it. That's the T. It's easier. You don't even need us. Like, okay, ma'am, what score do you need to pass for your visa application? 5! Go home! I mean, come on. I don't want to see you ever. Okay? You don't need to answer all the questions correctly. Like, eh, sana sagot ko kasi alam ko yun yung tama. Eh, sabi ni sir, magmali daw ako ng ilan. So, i-BB ko na lang. Pasa pa rin siya. Napakadali ang GT. Huh? Okay? So, GT task ka man. Sino po ang may kailangan lang dito ng 4? Pucha. Totoo ba? Alam niya, sa totoo lang, it's a good thing na wala ako lagi dito sa branch. Na wala ako lagi dito sa branch. Kasi tatanungin ko yan eh. Ano pong module? Saan pong bansa pupunta? Ano pong score ang kailangan? Or, naku ma'am, di niyo po kami kailangan. No? Tambay lang po kayo lagi sa SM. Mag-exam po kayo after 2 weeks. Kaya-kaya niyo lang. Kailangan niyo lang pong alagaan ng mental health niyo. No? Yung pang-re-review niyo po, pang-facial niyo na lang para fresh kayo sa exam. But that's the thing. Or, lie. Actually, meron na ako na encounter. Meron ako na encounter na naka 3.5 sa speaking. Pero hindi ko siya sadyante, ha. Reviewer, reviewee siya sa kabilang, sa kalaban ng branch. Ah, sa kalaban na review center dito. Yung siya, nag-review. Niraan talaga yun. Niraan lang. No? Okay. 3.5. Lumipat siya dito sa amin. Naka 5.5 siya. Wala. Wala pa akong kilala. Hindi ka babagsak, hindi ka lalag, bababasa form kung hindi mo siya sasadyain. Okay po? So doon po sa mga nagtaas ang kamay sa 4, 4.5, sino 4.5? Walang bababasa 4.5. Na, si ma'am. Sinak lang ito. Sinak na lang. Kaya pang tayo dapat. Confidence. Right? Kasi, guaranteed yan. Wala na. Game over. Tapos ang laban. Sa linggo? Kahit sa linggo ka lang mag-review, ma'am. So sa isang linggo, isang beses lang pumasok, mapasakta. Sasabi sa'yo, magmaka lang na isang beses. Ay, naka-6 pa ako. As pa ka ma-overqualify pa ako. Ang gugulat sa kami. Ano po siya kanina? Academic. Ano ba yung tone ng boses ko? Academic, I have some bad news for you. Ah, by the way, I always tell you guys this, that I don't want to see students coming after their test is over. I know Akash here got the band score he needs, but your 2 exams, reading, right? And writing. He needs to pump those 0.5s back. That's why he's here. But the band score requirement, already got it. So again, ha, reading and writing are the dark horses of your exam. So you need to spend longer. How many times have we seen each other? Like 5, 6 times lang, eh, no? But look at the speaking score of Akash. 7? So reading is going to hurt. You're not going to take this seriously. Okay? So academic, especially academic. Nasa side na to. Dapat si ma'am, ilipat natin dito si sir. Kaya rin na. Oh, malamig pa. Diyan ka na lang. Kakanada-kanada ka pa, tapos iginawin ka lang pala dyan. Saan pupunta? Pamalamig din doon. Nasanay ka na sa 16 degrees, 12 degrees sa araw. Oh. Okay. Academic, I have some bad news for you. Because the difficulty level of your exam is, in the past, ha, is already considered difficult. One of my college classmates became my student back in 2018. His course, 8 in speaking, which is very impressive. You don't get to encounter that every day. And only 5 for the reading. Academic. Hindi yung pasok for the UK. But it became a blessing in disguise kasi nagamit na for the US. Tatlong beses mas mataas ang sahod dun. Sa UK kasi 120, 140 entry-level nurse. Sa US, 360K to 500K in a month. Kaya yung mga nurses na nakapag-US, pag balik sa Pilipinas, napakayayabang niya. Bilhin ko lahat ng buhay niya. Alright? So, more difficult. That is the bad news. Ah, do I have nurses here planning to go to the US? Okay. If you're a nurse planning to go to the US, you only have to pump your scores for speaking. That's it. If your score is 7 listening, 4 reading, imagine that, 4. That's actually a failing score, no? 5 writing, 7 speaking. If you add them together, you get the 6.5 OBS credit. And a band 7 in speaking. That will make you use this results to apply for US business school. So speaking lang po ang dapat ipasa ng mga nurses bound for the US. So again, you're only here for what? To learn how to do reading properly. Kasi if you will get the speaking score of 7, but the OBS will be, let's say, 6, hindi na-achieve yung OBS, it'll take you. Pero pwede naman yung combination ng score. So yung 7 ng speaking na yun, pwede mo siya i-combine dun sa next test mo. Which, again, huwag sana mangyari. That's why the first exam, the first attempt, must get the 7 in speaking and OBS of 6.5. And how to do that? Listening, reading, writing, you have to lift them up as well. Okay. Academic, you have the more difficult end of the stick compared to G. But let's take a look at this matter much more clearly. For academic, you have 3 longer passages to work. Meaning, it's quite a bit bulky. Pag nakita mo yung passage, nakaka-intimidate. Tumukol ba ako ng GED? Wala ata. Akad. Akad to. Sa akad. Ito isang passage, oh, isang page na to. May katuloy pa sa isang page. Sa GED, ang passage lang, eto lang. Picture-picture game nga lang yung GT. Yung nakaraan natin na practice, yung rice cooker. Ano daw yung rice cooker na nakapagluto ng brown rice? Nakalagay sa C. Yung cook brown rice with ease. Yung C ang sagot. Ganun lang po, natutuwa na si Ma'am. Ganun lang po ang GT. Yung academic, kukwestiyonin mo ang na? O questionin mo ang existence mo. Bakit ba? Kailangan mo kung paano. Kaya wala akong may gusto ng IELTS. Kaya sa time. But, in fairness, ha? In all fairness, ACAD and GT, they have the same word count. We're looking at around 2,700 to 3,600 words for the entire readings of this. Including the number of words sa question. So, you are still considered judged fair accordingly for both. Even though GT, you have more passages. ACAD, you have longer ones. Which, in my opinion, mas madali yung well-divided passages in the process. So now, there are 40 items you have to give answers to. Out of the 40 questions, you have to supply 30 correct ones for you to hit a band 7 if your module is academic. And for GT, for you to get a band 7, you need to rake up more points in the process, which brings you 34. Sir, let me clear this up. Both ACAD and GT will have the same number of questions, 40. Correct? Yes. But for me to get 7, if I'm GT, I have to get 34 points? Yes. What if I only got 30? What is my balance score equivalent? 6. Okay? So both ACAD and GT, I want you to bring this band 7, to put this band 7 as your target minimum score. Okay? Target minimum. What is your target band score? 9. 4. Pupunta ka lang dito. So, 4. No? 9 is your target band score. The reason why the name of this business is 9.09er because you want to unleash your potential in achieving this peak exactly. 9.0. So your target band score is 9. So pag naka 7, okay na. Kaya ako dyan, Lord. Thank you po. 7 is our target minimum. Okay? Clear? So similarities. So we talked about the differences between ACAD and GT, but they also have similarities. Both exams last for 60 minutes. There is a countdown timer shown on your screen if you are taking the computer-based test. And if this is pen and paper-based exam, there's literally a countdown timer flashed in front. So, nung nag-take ako ng exam sa Crown Plaza, sa Ortigas, naka-malaking TV yun. LCD na screen. Tapos kulay pula pa. Parang bomba. Ano naman ito? Ano naman siyang ganun? No extra time is provided after the hour allotted for the test. Please, please, please take a good note of this. Are not given extra time just for you to transfer. Because in the listening test, for the pen and paper based category, you are given 10 minutes just to bring everything you have taken note of during the listening phase to the answer sheet, which is a separate, separate entity, a separate time. For example, the listening phase different from transfer phase if it is pen and paper based. But for the computer based exam, for the listening, you will only be given 2 minutes. This is not for you to transfer everything, but only for you to check which ones you missed. Because everything that you have input, you have strategically taken note of during the listening phase, is automatically uploaded to the virtual research. That's why it's only 2 minutes. This is computer-based. And for the reading, which is, again, exactly what my discussion is about today, you are not given any extra time at all. So when the time is over and there are some questions left unanswered, they get to be left unanswered forever. Oh, forever. Hmm. Okay, so one thing for you to increase your chances of getting higher band score is to ensure that you will have answers to all the questions. So let's do the math. If you have 40 items and you have 60 minutes, how many minutes, how much time do you have to spend per item? 1.5 exactly. I don't ask Filipinos when it comes to mathematics. They always, that's it. 1.5 minutes. 1 minute 30 seconds. 90 seconds per item. So kung ikaw yung tipong test taker na, ay, galing-galing naman, ganun pala yung paggawa ng mga, ano, cute. Yung pala yung mga pinagdadaanan ng mga polar bear, kawawa naman pala sila. Ini-enjoy mo pa. Ubusan ka na ng time. You're not here to enjoy the passage. You're here to hunt for answers fastest, most accurate way you can. The different types of questions require different test-taking strategies, which I will be enumerating during the latter part of my discussion. Okay? So if you are going to read everything, listen to me, you're going to read everything entirely, you will not pass the test. Okay. 2018, he attended the symposium sa Crown Plaza Ortigas, conducted by none other than Dan Golden. He is the senior executive of operations for the British Council in the IELTS for the European continent. Siya mismo, live in flesh. Siya po ay kamukha ni Santa Claus. Bearded guy, white hair, chubby. Naiwan sa attic for 2 years. Medyo marumi siya, tingnan. So yun po siya. Ang diniscuss sa amin for the first half was listening and reading. And he told us a very interesting story that one of his colleagues, imagine ha, for you to become a faculty member from the University of Cambridge, which exactly where Dan came from, which again, ha, by the way, where your exams are made in University of Cambridge, by the way, FYI. One of his colleagues is faculty there. And that faculty member who have taken the examination failed the reading test. Can you imagine? A faculty member of University of Cambridge, a natural born British citizen. Ano ba tinuturo niya? Again, college deans of College of Literature bumagsak sa reading. As expected, perfect score sa lahat. Except reading, where that person got. Sabi niya, Dan, I will be taking my examination next week. Do you have any tips? Sabi ni Dan, okay, just make sure you don't read everything. The following week, that colleague of Dan's entered the faculty room with this gesture. She cannot show his face to Dan because she only got 5. Guys, all of her answers were correct, by the way. All of her answers were correct. She was only able to manage to reach to number 25 because she literally read everything. Sir, are you crazy? The title of the test says reading. And you're telling us not to read? Yes. You just have to look for the clues in the question, search for those keywords to help you point exactly where you can find the answers, and just write the answer. That's it. That is the goal for reading. For you, answer every question the fastest way you can. And trust me, you will not be able to do that if you will read everything. Test-taking stamina could be depleted here. It could make you dizzy. Nakahilo to. So you're searching for things that sometimes are not even there. It can make you doubt your self-confidence in the process. It will make you question your own existence as well. Again, difficulty level of this exam is no joke. And we haven't even seen the most difficult exam yet, because right after this, the reading test, your writing exam follows. So you have to learn how to preserve your effort and energy during the listening and reading test, ensuring that they will be getting the effort they deserve, but not compromising your energy level, which must be saved for later in the writing test. Again, I keep on hyping up the writing test because tomorrow will be a writing discussion. It's going to be one hell of a difficult discussion. Please, please understand the difference between the exam. This listening is the easiest test even without review. You can pass. What is your score in listening? 7. Well, as expected, with or without review, or regardless of how many practices you did, 7 is going to be what we should expect as the bare minimum. Kaya-kaya. But reading and writing could ruin your dreams. Again, ha? IELTS can make or break your dream. Oftentimes, I've seen people give up just because their reading and writing tests are done. So, what's the difference between pen and paper based with a computer exam? Well, for a computer exam, here's what we do. Are you seeing this? There's so many lines. You're literally allowed to underline keyword. Okay? You underline mo talaga yan. But for the reading test, computer-based exam, hindi mo pwedeng guhitan yung screen eh. Huh? But you can highlight. Which do you think is much easier? Highlighting or underlining? Highlighting. Bakit? It pops up eh. The color is going to pop up. So you can identify it much easier. This allows the candidate to easily compare and contrast kasi pwede mong itapat yung question dun sa part kung nasaan yung passage. And like here, flip-flip mo yan, no? Ingay-ingay, sabi yung katabi mo, saksakin kita mamaya. Dito. Abwisit yung ganong katabi. Sa exam 2 kasi, you share siguro table twice this length, mga ganyan. Nasa dulo ka, nasa dulo yung isa. 1 meter apart. Yun po yung requirement. Siyempre, pag may nagbura na nagbura dyan, nagsulat na nagsulat, maalog din yung table. So, factor din yan. Na, sa computer-based, chill-chill lang. Very chill, very demure. And the referencing is way, way easier. So, panoorin muna natin.
In the reading test, the text appears on the left and the questions on the right. To see all the text and the questions, you'll need to use both scroll bars.
Okay, so you can literally put the passage and the questions right beside each other by dragging the cursor left and right, na? Up and down. Ay, mali.
And the questions on the right. To see all the text and the questions, you'll need to use both scroll bars. For some questions, you need to choose an answer. If you want to change your answer, click on a new answer. If you want to leave a question unanswered, click on the answer again. To look at the next question, just click on the question itself. For some questions, you need to choose more than one answer.
So in situations like this, where you have to choose multiple answers, if you're going to only click one and the instruction tells you two, your answer is automatically wrong. So always consider what the instruction tells you. All right?
If you want to change any of your answers, click on the answer you want to change and then click on your new answer. If you want to leave any of the questions unanswered, click on the answer again. For some questions in the reading test, you need to choose which paragraph or section contains the information listed in the table.
So this is roughly similar to matching headings to paragraphs. But unlike in the case of literally writing your answers like paragraph A or B or C, you just have to click it. So you notice how that in the reading exam, particularly in the computer-based test, it is much more interactive than the pen and paper-based one. You just have to click, you just have to sometimes drag and drop, you just have to interact with what is in front of your screen.
Remember to scroll to read all the text. For each question, click on the correct space in the table. If you want to change an answer, click on your new answer. If you want to leave the question unanswered, click on the answer again. For some questions in the reading test, you need to click on a heading for a paragraph or section and move it into the gap. If you want to change your answer, move another heading into the gap. If you want to leave the question unanswered, move the heading back. And for some questions, you need to write your answer on a gap in a diagram. If you wish, you can also highlight sections of text. To do this, left-click and drag your cursor over the section of text or question you wish to highlight. Then right-click and select the highlight option. To remove highlighting from the text, right-click on the highlighted area and select clear. If you wish to remove all highlighting from the screen, right-click on a highlighted area and select Clear All. You can also make notes on a section of text. To do this, left-click and drag the cursor over the section of text or question you want to make notes about. Then right-click and select the Notes option. Your chosen section of text will be highlighted and a yellow notepad will appear. You can write your notes on this. Click on the cross in the notepad to hide your notes. To see your notes again, click on the highlighted section of text. If you want to see which areas of highlighted text have notes, move the cursor slowly over each area of highlighted text. If a small orange box appears, it means that the highlighted text contains notes. To remove notes from text or questions, right-click on the highlighted area and select Clear.
Isa pa ba? Okay. Charot lang. So again, the most important skill for reading tests, regardless of whether this is pen and paper based or computer based testing, taking down notes, writing notes, highlighting clue words, which will then allow us to identify the words relevant to both the question and the passage. Well, you know, other referencing techniques are also needed for better understanding of the context. As I've mentioned before, one student claimed na, sir, even after attending your major lecture, which is what the lecture is all about today, I still am not able to get 7 in my practices. Just keep on getting 6.5, 6. So frustrating that I've been here for 4 months already. But after attending the minor lecture relevant for understanding context clues, which is vocabulary 1, if I'm not mistaken, consistently, nakaka 8 na siya, naka 8.5 pa siya. So, Vocab 1 is by far the most important minor lecture relevant to the reading subtest because this gives the candidate better understanding of the passage to compare as reference through the use of context. Unfortunately, the words from the question is not the same as the words found in the passage, right? You would understand that oftentimes they are paraphrased version of each. So it makes us difficult to figure out exactly where they are located, or we will be doubting na ito nga ba yung hinahanap ko, di ba? So by understanding context clues, it will make this easier. So example, the respiratory system functions to switch gases between the lungs and the outside surroundings. This is exactly what we saw in the question. But when you refer to the passage, let's say this is located in paragraph 5, the main responsibility of the respiratory system is to exchange. So from the question word switch, now in the passage it is exchange. Are they the same? Substances, gases, body's respiratory organs, lungs, outside surroundings, external surroundings, are they the same? So in comparison, the words, if you are going to translate it, mean the exact same thing for both question and the passage in this example. Again, even though the words are the same, even though the words are not the same, they mean the same. Okay? Questions?
Okay.
So in the exam, there are different types of questions that you will be able to find throughout the test for the 40 items involved. So we have the summary completion, matching headings to paragraphs, identifying the writer's views, pinakapaborito ng lahat si multiple choice, no? Madali lang kasi yan, no? Selecting factors, table completion, matching causes and effects, sentence completion, short answer questions, which will require you to write no more than 3 words. These are all the types of questions that exist in the current exam. So for you to respond to whatever question you may encounter, there are 3 steps we will follow. First is you read the question. Again, you're hearing this correct. You will not read the passage first. Ano muna ang babasahin? Question. Then, look for keywords dun sa question. After that, find those keywords you have identified sa passage, whether they are the same word or whether they have the same meaning. Again, you will be having a tough time finding the exact same words, if that is your intent, because you will not find those words existing. So, for example, nakalagay doon, habitat Tapos nakalagay doon is niche. So even though magkaibang word yon, they mean the same. So you have to consider. And while reading the passage, you answer the question, understanding the timing. So I don't want you guys to glance at the clock every now and then. So if you have three passages for academic, you have 1 to 13, 14 to 27, 28 to 40. Ganun po yung hatian yan eh. So basically, for academic, you just have to spend 20 minutes per passage. So that's a countdown timer. So from 60 to 40 minute mark, halimbawa, 38 minutes, tsaka ka palang pumunta sa passage number 2. Sabi mo sa sarili mo, okay, I am behind. I'm lagging behind. I have to do my passage too much faster because naglag ako ng 2 minutes. Are you getting the point? Okay. So, if you encounter a very difficult question which will require you to at least spend beyond the 1 minute 30 seconds mark, minsan nga sabi ng student, sir, nakaka 5 minutes na ako dito sa tanong, nahihilo na ako. Ino pa ako na hindi ko makita. Lubayan muna. Totoo. Because by spending 5 minutes for that one particular question na baka wala naman talagang sagot in the first place dahil not given yung answer, you're wasting time. You're compromising the other items. Eh kung hindi mo pala siya pinag-aksaya ng oras sa 5 minuto, tatlong item pa sana yung sagotan. Ayan. Nagets? Skip it. Pwede naman balikan mamaya eh. Unlike listening, na it's linear. Reading, you can skip items and return to it afterwards. Okay? So first, let's talk about the more difficult types of questions. Matching headings. Now, why do you think matching heading superior gaps is a difficult type of question? Bakit daw? Wala po bang tao dito? Exactly. In matching headings superior gaps, you literally have to read entire paragraphs because oftentimes, if you only read the beginning of the paragraph, there's a twist in the middle. And in the end, it's a totally different story. So instead of looking for the answer, which is letter A, you're supposed to answer the opposite because of the twist in the middle. So you have to finish it, which is exactly what we're trying to avoid. Are we trying to avoid reading entire paragraphs? Yes. Because if you read the entire thing, it's wasting your time. Right? But people in matching headings of paragraphs don't have a choice. We have to do speed reading, skimming and scanning technique. You know what? Exams are actually determined whether they are difficult or not based solely on whether they contain more matching headings to paragraphs and more true-false not given than others. Ulitin ko lang. Alaman natin kung mahirap ang exam, kung marami kang matching headings to paragraphs, at kung marami kang true-false. Sadly, questions become increasingly more difficult during the latter part of the year. Okay? Again, this is not meant to discourage you in any way, but people taking their exams during the burn months, October, November, December, you're going to notice the trend, ang pababa yung scores. I'm not trying to discourage you. Especially especially GT. GT, if you're only looking for a band of 4, you got affected dito sa trend. So in reality, ha, if the exam is during the first quarter, alam ba to? 2019 yata. 35? No, 33. 32 out of 33 test takers. 33 kami dito, literally. Salang bumalik. Brad. So GT, walang ganun sa inyo. Akad lang. Alright? Is there a difference if you have 7 paragraphs and 7 headings versus if you have 7 paragraphs and 10 headings? Yes. This second example, 7 paragraphs and you have 10 headings. This is a more difficult type of test. Why? Because there will be 3 fluffs. May tatlong joker dyan na answer na malapit doon sa tamang sagot. It may confuse you. So it adds to the difficulty level that is already in place. Sample. This is your passage. This are your headings. Imagine, ha? Mas mahirap pa po ito. Why? You have 6 paragraphs. You have 10 headings to match. Again, if you don't understand the concept of matching paragraphs to headings, you are just being asked, what title do you think best fit this paragraph? What is the main idea of this paragraph? Now, I told you a while ago that we look at the question first. Right? We read the passage, we search for where they are located, and then we answer it. Just like that. But for matching headings to paragraphs, you can choose either. You can choose whether you want to read the paragraph first or you want to read the heading first. Which do you think I would recommend? Paragraph first or heading first? Wrong. Paragraph first. Bakit? Paano kung nagpunta ko sa heading, tapos yung heading na hinahanap ko, yung pala yung bluff? Are you getting the point? Yung pala yung panggulo. Eh di, lalo nang nagulo. Nagets yan? So, question 1 literally tells you, paragraph B. O, punta ko dito kay paragraph B. I just have to read it quickly. I have to understand the main idea behind it, which again, I will be doing right now. Back in the 1950s, anthropologist Edward P. Hall described how social rules of time are like silent language for a given culture. So what am I going to underline or highlight? Social rules until culture. Yan. These rules might not always be made explicit, he stated. Yan. But they exist in the air. You highlight him again. It describes how variations in the perception of time can lead to misunderstandings between people from separate cultures. An ambassador has been kept waiting by a foreign visitor needs to understand that if his visitor just mutters an apology, this is not necessarily an insult. Hall wrote, you must know the social rules of time of country to know at what point apologies are really due. So first, it doesn't make sense. If I'm going to read it first time, it doesn't make sense. But because I have figured out something or words that saturated the paragraph itself, that this is about time and perception of culture, because each culture, they have their own rules. That's it. So that is exactly what I'm going to search from the bunch of headings. So again, did the paragraph I just read, all about time and technological understanding and development, is it? No. Is it about a problem for those researching attitudes of time? No. Is it about learning the loss of time for intercultural understanding? Lagot kayo. Is there intercultural understanding in the passage I just read? Culture. Did you see culture? Did it appear 3 times in the passage? Yes. Is it about learning the rules of time? Which is synonymous to law? Pucha. No? So, that paragraph literally is about learning the laws of time for intercultural understanding. I hit the jackpot. This is my answer. That's how you do it. Again, isa pa. Magbigay ng mga sarili. Okay. Umpisa pa lang naman eh. Yan. Ilapit na natin. C. Social psychologist Robert V. Levine says, one of the beauties of studying time is that it's a wonderful window on culture. Hala, patay. Culture na naman. Again, ha, nakakalito ha, but you have to read it entirely for you to understand the meaning behind it. You get answers on what cultures value and believe in. Ako, culture? Levine and his colleagues have conducted so-called pace of life studies in 31 countries. In, ito yung book, naka-italicized, Geography of Time, published in 1997, Levine describes how he ranked the countries by measuring 3 things. Walking speed on urban sidewalks, how quickly postal clerks could fulfill a request for a common stamp, and the accuracy of clocks. From the data he collected, he concluded that the 5 fastest-paced countries are, and the 5 slowest are, boom. So, what does this mean? So, Robert Levine was also trying to understand the nature of time and cultural correlation. So what he did was he conducted a research. And after doing the research, there are now 5 fastest and 5 slowest countries. Nakuha? All right, so hanapin natin to. Is this paragraph about time and technological development? Is it about problem for those researching attitudes of time? Again, this is about research, but there were no attitude problem mentioned. This is not an answer. Learning the loss of time for intercultural understanding, this was answered, taken by item number 1. Time and individual psychology, there was no mention of it at all. Comparing the value of time for different groups of workers. Did we compare value of time here? Actually, they compare the use metrics to compare walking speed, how quickly postal clerks, at yun lang po yung nag-iisang groups of workers dito. Wala nang iba. So this is not going to be the answer. Research and conclusions on the speed different nationalities live at. Was there a research about speed of different countries? Do you have 5 fastest and 5 slowest? Yes. Was there a conclusion that there are 5 fastest and there are 5 slowest? So your answer is going to be okay. Just to clear things up. Sige, basahin mo kung papasok to. History of time measurement. Hindi. Pasok ba dito yung attitudes, time, and authority cross? Hindi. Variation of theoretical views of time. Hindi rin. Wala nabasa ang theory. Attitudes of time. Ala. Hindi. So, ang pinakamalapit dito is may research na kinundak si Robert V. Levine. Yes, anong title lang? Geography of time. May conclusion ba siya? And from the data he collected, he concluded na may iba't ibang bilis ang iba't ibang. Nakuha. Patay. Yari na. Again, ha? Matching headings paragraphs is one of the most difficult types of questions in the IELTS. But it is nothing, nowhere near close as how difficult true, false, not given is going to be. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the shit. This is the real shit. Real piece of shit, right? True, false, not given. If you encounter a true, false, not given question for every passage, you are unlucky. Did you encounter true, false, not given for every passage? First and last. It's a average difficulty. But if you encounter true, false, not given for every passage, you're the unluckiest person on the planet. It happens, huh? They have to be aware of it. So oftentimes, may yes, no, not given. In some cases, you just have to write the acronym, T if the answer is true, F if the answer is false, i.e. if it's, hindi po yan pang exam ng OB, ha? I.e. means insufficient evidence. Kaya siya not given then. So, when we were in primary school, during our elementary days, did you study here in the Philippines during your elementary days or in India? You have true or false questions there? So when we were young, there were only true and false, right? Which makes it easy. You have to just pick between the two. If it's somewhat near, I guess I'm gonna have to pick true. If it's nowhere as near as the statement, then my answer is going to be. But because of the presence of not given, it made the equation complicated. Complicated things up. No? So first, let us understand the nature of true. Listen to me, guys. Look at me. You answer true if the statement from the question matches exactly. Exactly, yeah. The information in the passage. Accurately. When you say accurately, there's no misconceptions involved. Kung 0.3 nakalagay dyan, 0.3 din dapat sa'yo, hindi 0.4. Any minor deficiency, medyo patuta ka na. Okay? Any minor inconsistency between the passage and the question, you do not consider true as an answer. So, take a look at this question. In the world today, there are at least 1 million students learning English abroad. As I've mentioned previously, you should not expect words to appear exactly as they are from the question in the passage. So take a look at the passage here. There are around more than 1 million students studying the English language in another country. So from at least, it is not more than. But they mean the same. Pas sobra isang million. So anong sagot? Because they accurately represent one another. Excuse me. The answer is again, you answer true if the words, data, information given in the question matches the one in the passage in the most accurate way, regardless of whether the words are different. They mean the same, they accurately represent one another, they are interchangeable. Your answer is clear? Question? Again, huh? True is going to be easy. That's it. Are you deceiving? Yes. Okay, true. That's easy, right? Is that difficult? No. That's actually the easiest thing to do here. That's why in the exam, you will not encounter true very regularly. Bakit? Eh, madali eh. It's easy. Why would examiner give those questions? They wouldn't. Because if you fail, you didn't reach your score requirement, what are you going to do? You take the exam. You don't have any other choice. So when you do retake the exam, who gets richer? The IELTS, the British Council. Last year, there were 23,000 test takers, British Council pa lang. 23,000 times was 12,000. Daang million po pinag-uusapan natin dito. Sabi nila, kung ipapagsak natin sila, binituhin natin sila sa tanong, pwede pa natin tumating sa dahan. This is a business, after all. What if 30 ka na, 7 ka na, naging 20 na in fact because you misunderstood the true false of given question? You don't want that to happen. You don't want you to suffer from this. Okay? When do we answer false? Read the question. In the world today, there are at least 1 million students learning English abroad. Okay? That is my clue word, 1 million. So I searched for it in the passage. And in the passage, it says, on the 7th paragraph, again, enabled me to jump to exactly where the answer can be found. Kasi unang-una, kung babasahin mo yun from start to finish, mababasa mo na siya hanggang 7th paragraph, siguro it will take you roughly 7 minutes to do. Saka mo palang mahasagutan ito. So napaka-time consuming. That's the importance of skimming and scanning using referencing. Kita mo, 1 million ang aking hinahanap. Saan ba dito may mga 1 million? Study English. Okay, 7 paragraph. So nakasave ka ng time, you don't have to read paragraph 1 to 6. Jump right to paragraph 7. English. Okay. There are no more than 1 million students studying the English language in another country. So dun sa question, it says more than 1 million. Ang sabi naman dito sa passage, less than 1 million. So the first thing you will tell yourself is this. The answer is not true. That's the first thing you tell yourself. There's a difference, all right? There's a discrepancy, even a minor inaccuracy. You remove true from the equation. They're only left between two, either false or not given, which makes the chances of you getting the right score better. Pataasin niya yung chance na makuha mo yung tamang sagot. Kasi dalawa na lang yung option. Na-eliminate mo na yung hindi tamang sagot. From 33% chance, this is now a 50-50% game. Okay? Now, the answer here is false because, number one, they are opposite of one another. So look for opposite words. Halimbawa, nakalagay sa question lowest, nakalagay sa passage highest. Nagigets po yung point? Okay. Nakalagay sa question first, nakalagay sa passage last. So kahit hindi first, hindi last, nakalagay sa, excuse me, nakalagay sa question first, nakalagay sa passage second, your answer is false. Okay? It doesn't necessarily mean that it has to be north sa question, south sa passage for it to be false. Kahit north tapos east sa passage, it still becomes false because of the inaccuracy between the discrepancy between them. doesn't necessarily have to be opposite, the polar antonym of it. It just have to be a different word, a different entity, an inaccurate data representation. Sabi kay question, a person is considered having a fever if his or her temperature exceeds 39.8 degrees Celsius. Nakalagay sa passage, 37.5. That's an inaccuracy. The answer is false. Nagets? Yeah. So this is the first example of false, because I have another type of false. So this one, it says proximity to home, but it says in the passage, economic factors, you tell yourself this, they are not accurate representations of one another. I will remove true from the equation. It doesn't fit the category of not given any way. So my answer here is false, because simply proximity to home is not economic factors. Economic factors is never, has not been, is never going to be proximity to home. They're not alike. They are different. The answer is false. Clear? Okay. Ito na. Ito na po ang nakakalipong part sa false and not given. Again, I don't want you to be confused with the false and not given part. With the true part, only with the false and not given part. No? So, this example is what we refer to as missing information. So again, ha, sasabihin kasi nila, okay, the lab card shows student's name and number. Lab card shows student's name, course, and number. Parang halos parehas lang sila eh. Meron lang konting pagkakamali. Baka pwedeng true na dito. No! Again, ha, even there is only a minor inconsistency, you remove true from the equation. Alis mo agad yan. So you're only left between two options. It's either false or not given. Since the not given requirements will be discussed later pa, what you already know about is how to determine false. And by understanding the nature of this type of comparison, you will understand exactly why this is false. Okay? Una, missing info from the question. Sorry, ilang kayo magkakapatid? Ha? Four. Sabi ni ma'am, tapat mo? Alam mo ba sila, sir, dyan? Tapos sila magkakapatid. So the passage said four, but the question says three. What's your answer? Sabi ni dyan, boy, that's false. Because not three, but four. Mamaya tayo mag-example yung four sa five, ha? Mamaya yun. My example is sobra a passage. There's an excess information in the passage. And there's a missing piece of info in the question, which makes the question not absolutely correct. Again, ha, this is going to be the turning point why we consider this as false. Since it is not entirely, absolutely correct, it's false. That's it. That's the low explanation for a much easier explanation. Napakasimple. Kulang may question. Sobra may passage. False. One, two, three. Kulang question. Sobra passage. Wala nang pag-iisipan pa. False. You remember this game, right, Akash? I use their Indian words for this. There's a missing piece of info in the question, and the passage has an excess, like one or two pieces of information more than the passage, you answer false right away. So long explanation. The reason why this is false is because number one, if you compare them side by side, they are not accurate representations of one another, which makes us remove true from the equation. So we're only left with the question that says there are only two pieces of information, name and number. But on the other hand, on the passage, it says name, force, and number. So force is a missing integral part of the question, which makes this not absolutely correct. And because it's not absolutely correct, it can only mean one thing, it is considered false. In the shortcut version, Tagalog version, wala kay question, sobra kay passage, cooking in apples. Ano pag-uusapan? It's always going to lead you to false. Clear? Langhapin niyo muna eh. Wala sa uutot ha? Okay? Alright? Questions? For false? None? Sure? Can I move on to not given? This is going to be bloody. Alright? Not given is bloody. Ayan na. The lab card shows the student's name, course, number, year 11. How many pieces of information did you see? Four. The lab card shows the student's name, course, and number. The number of information we see here is three. So this is the first thing you need to do. How many options? True, false, not given, right? What are you going to do? Remove true from the equation. So you're only left with two. It's either false or not given now, which makes the chances of you getting the proper score much higher. Mas mataas yung chance mo makuha yung tamang sagot kasi dalawa na may pagpipilian. From 33%, we're now down to 50-50 game. Okay? So, why not given? Okay. Sir, ano pangalan ng kapatid mo? Jeff? Jim? Puro J, ha? Joanne? Tsaka John. Jeff, Jim, Joanne, John. Tingnan nyo ha, lista natin. Jeff, Jim, Joanne, double N-E, tsaka John. Yung John mo, A-A-H-N? Okay. Tapos sabi ni ma'am, kasi ano to, ismosas eh. Alam mo ba, sila John, lima sila magkakapatid. Si Jeff, si Joaquin, si Joanne, tsaka si Jim, tsaka si John. Sabi ni John, narinig niya, huy, wala naman akong sinabing Joaquin na. Wala naman akong binigay na Joaquin, tama ba? I didn't supply that information. Not given. Why? Okay. Because? Ah, sorry. Dito pala si Joaquin. Siya pala yung question, sorry. Yan. Wala naman ako sinabing Joaquin ah. Wala naman kaming ganun kapatid. Ano yung dinadagdag mo dyan? Di naman kasali. It was not mentioned. It was not provided. It is not given. Simply put, hindi siya included. So saan lang siya nag-exist? Sa question lang. But in the passage, hindi. Kaya, if you notice this very quickly, false and not given when it comes to the enumerated pieces of information, they are opposite. In the false category, the excess is in the passage, which makes the question not absolutely true, hence it's considered false. But this time around, the excess is in the question, which makes this additional piece of information non-existent in the passage. It is not provided. It is not included in the passage. Hence, it becomes not given. That is the, shh, makinig muna, uy, may magsispag cellphone. Which makes this the, ano? Which makes this the long explanation. Ano yung shortcut? Kulang, saan? Passage, sobra, question, not given. Tapos. Tandaan niya, totoo. Bahaba pa lang pala. Kulang, sobra, not given. Okay. So false tayo. Kulang question, sobra passage, false. So not given. Sobra question, kulang passage, not given. Ano? This is the first example of not given because we have another example of not given. In this example, this can make you doubt yourself kasi oftentimes, there is a question they are trying to let you find in the passage that does not even exist there. May pinapahanap sa'yo, wala naman doon. Naranasan nyo na ba yun? Naranasan nyo na? Halimbawa, may hinahanap ka. Have you experienced that, Akash? Let's say your phone is missing and you remembered you left it somewhere in your room. So, you were searching for your room, flip the bed, correct? That works. You spent hours finding for your phone. You cannot find it. And your mom was like, okay, I just came home. I bought some groceries. Oh, Cash, I found your phone in the car. You left it there last night. Fuck, right? You're searching for something that is not even there to begin with. Because it's located somewhere. That's what makes not given the most even entity in the reading. And this is the examiner's favorite. Because you will waste your time, right? You will read the entire passage. You will read it round two. You're giving up. Bawa, jowa mo. Siguro, pag-asa pa. Magbago siya. Hindi mo na ako susuko. Eh, wala mo. Wala mo. Tatlo ka lang may pasa ako. Eh. Baka, magbawasan ko sa... Sumuko ka na. Just, in the reading test, you need to know when to give up. So the first clue, you are already spending 2.5 minutes for an item and you can't find it. Tell yourself that you will find it later. Skip it. Skip the part. Because in some cases, for true false not given, paragraph 1, question 1. Paragraph 2, question 2. Paragraph 3, you skip it. Paragraph 4, sorry, question 4, paragraph 3. So meaning, there's no space between the question number 2 and 4 because the answers were on paragraph 2 and 3. Papaliwanag ko mamaya, I'll be giving you some visual representations. But just for this idea, it means that there's number 3 that you cannot find. You skip it. It was sandwiched between answers 2 and 4. And the activity given to you is appearing in order. That means one thing. The answer is not given for item number three because it is not even there to be given. So, for candidates who have already experienced this, oftentimes you would feel na, parang, ayan yun, may hunch ka. True. Paano do that? Have you ever experienced that? Have you ever experienced something that feels something is wrong? Right? Like you have a boyfriend or your husband. Sino dito yung mga asawa na mga babae taas naman? Mga asawa, mga boyfriend. Yan. Yeah. Naras yung one time, parang, ang masyado mabait tatay, asawa ko ngayon. Parang may mali eh. Huh? Imbestigahan mo ngayon. Kasi ang kutob din sa tama. Pinapalimin naman yung mga even if you think the answer is true, you have the slightest doubt, trust me, consider not given. Okay? Are ready? Again, huh? For Zoom participants, which we only have, sadly, two participants, Aris and Renaline, I invite you to participate because if you will not participate, I will kick you out of the meeting. Unfortunately, you don't have the ability to unmute yourself. So you can only use the chat feature of our Zoom. So unahin muna natin yung mga nasa branch. Question. The lab card shows the student's name, course, and number. In the passage, it says the lab card does not show the student's name, course, number, and year level. What is your answer? Who says true? If someone here will answer true, that means I failed as a coach. Okay. Who says false? Wow. A lot. Who says not given? Meron pa? Not given? Wala. What about sa Zoom, Aris and Revelin, type your answers now. Okay. Sagot nila ay not given. Pareho kayong mali. Renaline at Aris. Huwag kayong magpapakita sa akin. Puruting ko kayo. Alam niyo kung bakit? Abay, show! Tsaka does not show? Not given? Saan kayo nakatira? Pupunta ko kayo ngayon. Ha? Alright. At kung hindi pa po sapat yun, naglagay pa po ako ng isa pang dahilan para maging false ang sagot. Name, course, and number, 3 pieces of info. Name, course, number, year level, 4 pieces of info. Kulang kay question? Sobra kay passage? Anong sagot? False. Oh, saan nyo na kayo kinuhay not given na yan? Aris and Renaline. Ha? Okay, kayo mauuna ngayon dito. Ito po ay hango sa mismong exam. Sabi sa question, there are subversive elements in children's literature. In the passage, it says, adults often fail to recognize the subversive elements in books their children read. Renaline and Aris, you go first. Bago ko magtanong dito. Okay. Andiyan pa ba kayo? Aris, ang nalali, tampo na ba kayo? Para sa loob nyo magtampo, dapat ako magtampo ha. Aris, Renaline ha. Okay. Unahin natin sila. Ang sabi ni Renaline ay true. Sabi ni Aris, excuse, hindi ako nakapakinig ni Maris kanina eh. Ah. Alright. Okay lang, Aris. Sige, meron naman tong replay. Gusto ko na mag-participate kayo dito sa game natin. Okay, tanong tayo dito sa branch. Ma'am, na naka-silver, ano yung tawag yan? Yeah, Paulo, anong sagot mo? Not given! Kaya?
False?
True? Oh. Sama-sama eh, no? Alam niyo lang yung... Not given tong nandito, not given sila. Kayo, false kayo parehas. Ito, true silang pare-parehas. Damay-damay ito eh, no? Okay. False. Pag kayong dalawa, nag-false, pipitik ko kayo. Ano? True. True. Sila dalawa magkadamay eh, no? Kasi sila sabay ko nga. False. Not given. False. The answer is not given. Okay. Sabi po sa question, let's crack it, no? Himayin natin, anatomical structure. Let's break it down to the molecular level. There are subversive elements in children's literature. What do you call this type of statement? We call this generalizing statement. In some cases, we call it over-generalizing. Like, niloko ako ng boyfriend ko. Lahat ng lalaki, mga manluloko. Okay, yun siya. Okay, yun po. Now, the passage clearly states that often, pag sinabing often, let's say often 7 out of 10. Ma, 7 out of 10, madalas. Adults often fail to recognize the subversive elements in books their children read. But there's no clear description whether in all types of children's literature, subversive elements exist. That's why this claim from the question is not specifically, look at the word I used, specifically. It is not specifically stated in the passage. That's what made this not given. Ayan. Sabi sa question, there is an unrealistic view of money in children's literature. And in the passage, it says, there should be a more realistic view of money in children's literature. What is it going to be? Simulan natin dito. Alright, true, false, not given. True, false, not given. False. Dati ko dadamayan ka niyo. Not given. False. No. False. True. False. Uy, dumamay. False then. Not given. What about you, Ranalyn and Aris? I have a clue. No? Sabi ni Aris, false. Sabi ni Ranalyn, false. Yan. The answer is not given. Bakit? Nagagalit na ako, bakit? Okay. Again, ha? Statement kanina, it's a generalizing statement. The same with this. There is an unrealistic view of money in children's literature. This is a very simple exercise. Can you see unrealistic view of money in the passage, dun sa right side? Can you see it? Hindi. What are we seeing? A suggestion. Pag kasi may should, yun po ay model of suggestion. Excuse me. Bawa, like, You know what? You should cut your hair. You should not smoke. You should save more money. Bibigay siya ng suggestion. So this unrealistic claim of money in the children's literature is not provided in the passage in a clear manner. Because what is in the passage is, kung nasa ang level tayo ng realism when it comes to money, whether it's unrealistic, semi-realistic, or very realistic, we should push it beyond this level where we're at. That is what the passage says. So it is not provided clearly. Hence, the answer is not given. So mauuna pong sumagot ang nasa Zoom, si Renalyn and Aris. Inland freight in United Kingdom is carried by road. That is the passage. Inland freight in United Kingdom is not carried by water. So Renlin and Aris, this will be your turn first. Tama po maging sagot ni Renalyn at ni Aris. Meron po sila sa akin 3 pesos GCash. Okay? Ang sagot ni Aris ay wala pa palang sa... Tama, may sagot na pala siya. Sagot ni Aris ay true. Ang sagot ni Renalyn ay not given. Renalyn, i-message mo sa akin ang iyong GCash number. Dahil tama po ang iyong sagot. Not given. So, sino nang guhula dyan ng false? Sabi kasi nila, ah, siguro pag carried by road, sabihin din nun, not carried by water. Kaya, pwedeng true din ito. Yan, ganun kasi yung thinking eh. Na? Guys, napakasimple lang po eh. Bakit ito not given? Nakita mo ba ito exactly dito? Hindi. So, hindi mo kailangan mag-overanalyze na ang ibig sabihin ng carried by road ay not carried by water. So, you don't have to overanalyze. You don't see carried by road in the passage, the answer is not given. Sabi sa question, Johnson has become more well-known since his death. Sabi kay passage, beyond the practical need to make order out of chaos, the rise of dictionaries associated with the rise of the English middle class, who were anxious to define and circumscribe the various words to conquer lexical as well as social and commercial. It is highly appropriate that Dr. Samuel Johnson, the very model of an 18th century literary man, is famous in his own time as in ours, should have published his dictionary at the very beginning of the heyday. Yan po is from an actual exam. I-highlight ko na po kung saan matatagpuan yung sagot. So what is your answer? Simulan natin kay ma'am dahil siya yung hindi sumagot kanina. True, false, or not given? Parang not given. Di ka sure. Parang lang, ha? Anong sagot mo? Hindi mo pa alam. Di ka, ma'am? False! Sagot ni ma'am. Ma'am? Wala pa po, sir. False? Not given? Uy, hindi kayo parehas ngayon. Not given? Na, uy, parehas pa rin kayo hanggang ngayon, ha? Not given? Not given? False? True! Really? That's a different answer from everyone else. Tuwa ka, lumukot sa nanay mo, ha? Given. False. False. Not given. Not given. Sino po ang nagsagot ng false? Taas kamay. Para lang ma-confirm. So, 1. Nag-false ka ba? 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. Sino pa nagsagot ang not given? Yan. Sino? Mga nasa Zoom, Renaline, Aris, may dumagdag tayong isa. May isa na tayong classmate. Si Myla. Alright, Myla, what is your answer? Aris, Myla, Renaline, true, false, or not given? Sabi ni Aris, false. Renaline and Myla, what is your answer? True, false, or not given? Sabi ni Renaline, not given. Si Renaline at si Aris ay lagi silang hindi magkasundo. Ano? Laging iba ang sagot nila sa isa't isa. Napansin niyo? Okay. So, ang sagot po natin dito ay bakit po kaya? Okay, let me explain. Ang sabi sa question, more well-known since his death. Ibig sabihin, upon death, Johnson became more popular. Tama ba? More popular. Now, according sa passage, as famous in his own time as in ours. Okay, tingnan nyo ha. Ida-drawing ko na lang. Ito po yung sabi sa question, more famous. Pataas ang trend. Ay, Diyos ko po. More famous. Dito siya namatay. Ito yung panahon natin ngayon. Masikat daw siya ngayon. Nakuha. Okay. Ang sabi sa passage, ito yung passage, kulay blue naman. Ito yung trend ng pagiging sikat ni Johnson. Yung blue po ba at yung red eh parehas? So, hindi. Kaya, false po ang sagot. Nag-drawing pa ako dito. Pag ito, hindi pa rin ako kuha. Okay. Okay. Planning to write dictionary for several years. So let me read. Johnson was a poet who raised common sense to the heights of genius. His approach to the problems that had worried writers throughout the late 17th and early 18th centuries was intensely practical. Up until his time, the task of producing a dictionary on such a large scale had seemed impossible without the establishment of an academy to make decisions about right and wrong usage. Johnson decided he did not need an academy to settle arguments about language. He would write a dictionary himself and contract for the dictionary with the bookseller Robert Bosley at a breakfast held at the Golden Anchor Inn near Holborn Bar on June 18, 1764. He was to be paid £1,575 installments, and from this it took money to rent 17 Gough Square, in which he set up his dictionary workshop. What is the answer? Not given. What about the others? True. Not given. True. Not given. Not given. Not nakikigi. Ano lang ito si ano eh. Aubrey eh. What's your answer? Not given. Is this voluntary or is she forcing you? Okay. What about you, ma'am? False. Not given. Okay, I have nothing to know about it. Ayun din, no? Ikaw mauna naman. False. O true. Okay, iba na kayo, di ba? True. Not given. False. True. False. Not given.
Ba? Pare-pare-pare.
Sa ulo? Guys, hindi mauubos yan. Puro true false not given lang yan. So the answer is the answer is not given. Bakit? Nakita nyo ba yung plano niya na for the past 5 years I've been thinking I should. Wala. There's no mention about his plan. It just happened. No? Mas madali ito. Dahil minarkahan ko na. Pag eto, nagkaiba-iba pa to ha. Ayan ha. Johnson set up an academy to help with the writing of his dictionary. Without the establishment of an academy. Tapos isa pa, pangalawang sentence, Johnson decided he did not need an academy. Pag eto, may sumagot ng iba, ay, maghablahan na lang tayo, mananampal na ako talaga. Totoo ito. No? Sasampal na ako ng estudyante. Without academy, he did not need an academy. Pag ayan po yung kakulitan niya, hindi niyo pa nakita. Sabi, ewan ko na lang po. Ano? Ano ang sagot? Sabi sa'yo sa nanay mo. False. You will analyze it first. False. False.
Iba pa eh.
False. Ay, salamat, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Sabi sa question, Johnson set up an academy. Sabi sa passage, without the academy, he did not need an academy. False. Okay. So this is an example that I would like you to see. How the question can affect the passage, ha? Pakita ko lang. Para makita nyo po yung difference ng not given sa false. Again, ha? Hindi po yung question ang pinalitan ko dito. Yung existence kasi ng word sa question yung kailangan nyo maintindihan in comparison to the passage. Because the important thing to understand about true false not given is by understanding the context of the question first. So, sabi sa question, standards at tertiary institutions are improving. Sabi sa passage, standards at tertiary institutions are deteriorating. Anong sagot dyan? False. Why? Because it says in the question that standards at tertiary institutions, it is mentioned, improving, but the standards for the passage is deteriorating. They are opposite. Again, even if it's not opposite, if they are differently worded, the answer is still going to be false. But take a look at this scenario. What if the passage states that the standards at primary institutions are improving? That's what makes this not given. Bakit? Kasi yung minention sa question, tertiary institutions, hindi naman yun yung minention dito. Kaya po, not given yung answer. So I just want you to understand ha, the nature of the question first before jumping into conclusions like that. Multiple choice. Ayan na. Choose the correct answer. According to the passage, which of the following statement is supported by recent research? Nakalagay dito, recent studies are showing that if you can take a 15 to 30 minute nap while at work in the afternoon, you'll be more alert, more energetic, happier doing what you do, more productive, and therefore more likely to get ahead. So, napping daw ba is an indicator of laziness? Hindi yon. Two-thirds of Americans sleep too much? Hindi din. Napping in the workplace is a current trend? Hindi rin. Short naps at work increases productivity? Paano mo nasabi? Ayan nakalagay. More energetic, happier doing, more productive. So it means it increases productivity. The answer is letter D. Ayan pa ulit. Yes, no, not given time. Guys, bakit? Madalas maglalabas sa exam eh. Siguro mga 15 items, puro true, false, not given. Ang laking bagay nung kung natama mo lahat yun. Alright? The number one cause of car accidents is fatigue. Lapit na natin. The number one cause of car accidents is fatigue. Oh, pare-pares yung sagot natin dyan. Ha? Sabi sa question, the number one cause of car accidents is fatigue. Sabi sa passage, he says, sleepiness is a leading cause of auto accidents, second only to drunkenness. Yes, no, or not given. Who says yes? Raise your hands. Taas yung mabuti, si Ma'am Karin. Ano ba, taas ba yun? Ang gagano ka na ng buhok? Kali, at kala ko, itataas ang kamay. Oh, yes, no, or not given? Who says no? Who says yes? Who says not given? Okay, wow. Not given. Guys, given. Binigay, oh. Binigay ba? Ang cause ng car accident? Oo, oh, but given ka dyan, na-mention eh. Ang tanong lang dyan, kung number one cause daw ba yung car, number one cause daw ba nun is yung fatigue. Oh, fatigue. Sabihin na natin, yung fatigue ay synonymous with sleepiness. Tama? Mm. Fatigue and sleepiness. Pagkaantok, pagkapagod. Sige, parehas na parehas lang. Sabi dyan, sleepiness is a leading cause. Isa sa mga top one. Isa sa mga nasa top rather, hindi top one. Second only, pero hindi siya number one. Siya ay pumapangalawa. Saan? Drunkenness. Kasi anong number one? Drunkenness, sunod, sleepiness. Anong sabi sa question? Anong sabi sa question? Sleepiness or fatigue yung number one. Anong sabi sa passage? Drunkenness and then number two, si sleepiness and fatigue. So anong sagot? Ay, salamat. Okay, the answer is false or no. Oh, people who nap in the afternoon are lazy. Sige, sandito yun. Ayan, ayan. People who nap in the afternoon are lazy. Ayan, people who nap in the afternoon. Tama ka, Aris. Tama ang sagot ni Aris. People who nap in the afternoon are lazy. Yan na, magkatabi na po sila. Sabi sa question, people who nap in the afternoon are lazy. Sabi sa passage, there is a tendency to associate afternoon naps with laziness and productivity. What's your answer? Yes, no, or not given? Raise your hand if your answer is yes. Raise your hand if your answer is no. Raise your hand if your answer is not given. Meron pa ba not given? Yes, sir. Matapang. Isa pong matapang. The answer for number three, people who nap in the afternoon are lazy, is not even. Bakit? Kasi naka-attend na si sir ng dati kong lecture. Alam mo yung nasa na. Tama ba, sir? Magkailang attend mo na ito? Pangatlo? Pangalawa. Pero bakit kaya? Ano sumobra? Ano sumobra dyan? Sabi dyan, there is a tendency to associate afternoon naps with laziness and non-productivity. This tendency to associate afternoon naps with laziness is a weak correlation. That's why they don't represent each other accurately. The answer is not given. Next. A nap in the middle of the day can improve your mood. Sabi sa floor. A nap in the middle of the day can improve your mood. Sabi dyan. If you can take 15 to 30 minute nap while at work in the afternoon, you'll be more alert, more energetic, happier doing what you do, more productive, and therefore more likely to get ahead. So, ang sagot natin sa number 4. A nap in the middle of the day can improve your mood. Yes, no, or not given? Yes. Kaya nakalagay, happier doing what you do. Ma-improve ba yung mood? Yes. Kaya yes. So 5, people who nap regularly live longer. Wala pong nabanggit dyan, kahit balibalik ka rin mo siya. Wala pong naka-indicate. So tama din ang sagot ni Renaline. Sagot sa 5 ay not given. Was not mentioned. 6, ito. Ganun na pag-usapan. 6. Sabi sa 6, majority of Americans sleep at least 8 hours a night. Pag yan hindi nyo pa po nakita ha. Pag ako, ha? May umiba dyan. Sabi sa question, majority of Americans sleep more than 8 hours at night. And it says in the passage, 2 out of 3, which is, by the way, people, the majority, no? Dahil ang minority is 1 out of 3. 2 out of 3 Americans get less than 8 hours of sleep a night. What is their answer? Yes, no, or not given? Salamat. Narinig ko din. Yung, no. Sabay sa pan. Means that you are learning something na nakatuwa. Yan po yung mga hangos sa totoong exam ha. So, magandang sign po yun. Label the diagram. Sabi kasi nila, huwag kasing ganun agad. Oh, titignan naman. Galit kayo agad. Nakita niyo pa lang yung picture. Oh. Titignan mo yan. Okay. Lalagay lang po tayo ng sagot dun sa 1, 2, and 3. Do we have clue? Yes. Asan yung clue? Sa number 1, nakalagay KM. Oh. Tignan nyo ha. Nakalagay KM. Hala, hanapin mo. Yung may KM. O sa number 2, may KM. Ako, baka magkapareha sila. Mapagbaliktad ko ah. O, ang simple. Eto, mas mahaba. Eto, mas maikli. So, yung mas malaking number, yun yung sagot sa 1. Kung mas maliit na number, yun yung sagot sa 2. O, hinahanap ko. So, sa buong passage, meron lang dalawang may KM. Isang 10,000 KM at isang 10 KM. Alright? So ngayon, if we're going to understand it clearly, sabi dyan, the distance from the equator to the pole is 10,000 kilometers. So, ito po yung equator. Ito po yung pole. 10,000. Tapos, from the ceiling height to the atmosphere is 10 kilometers. So, yun yung sagot sa 2. Ano naman to? Ha? Ipo-ipo na. Oh, may paliwanag din dyan. No? Kaya nga, tatlo sila. Madali mo sila makikita. Sabi yan, the air, therefore, splits up into several smaller loops or, ito daw yung tawag sa kanya, convection cells. Between the equator and each pole, meron daw tatlo nun. Tapos, within the circulation daw nun is north to south or clockwise. Tingnan niya natin. Sa pagitan po ba ng North Pole? Sorry. Ay yung aking marker. Sa pagitan ba ng pole and equator, may tatlo ba nun? 1, 2, 3. Mula ba north pa south? Ito, north pa south. Counterclockwise pala. Ang kanya movement. Yes. So siya yun. Sino siya? Si convection cells. So yun ang sagot natin sa 3. So madali po ba yung labeling a diagram? Diba? Again, walang kukumparahin sa true, false, not given, yes, no, not given. Yung po talaga pinakamahirap. Ganyan lang po siyang kadali. Trust me on this. Naman, yes, no, not given na naman. Di na naman natapos. Okay. Question number 1. Evidence so far indicates that further study of Shoemaker-Levy will be worthwhile. So if we're going to read the entire passage, in paragraph 3, it is mentioned that scientists studying the chemical composition of the spots on Jupiter where Shoemaker-Levy SL9 hit thought they might see evidence of water and oxygen. So the expected products when an icy comet vaporizes. Meaning, if we're going to study further, this will be important discovery for the scientific community. That's why yes is our answer. Next, there are no physical differences between asteroids and comets. Sabi din sa 2, ha? There are no physical differences. Sabi sa passage, asteroids are rockier than comets. So, the first thing you understand is that the claim for the question na wala silang pinagkaiba is wrong. Because it says in the passage very clearly that asteroids are rockier than comets. So what is your answer? Yes, no, or not given? No or false? Because it contradicts the statement from the passage. Next, tingnan nyo ha. Tingnan nyo po yung trend. Tingnan nyo yung trend. In question number 1, we got the answer from paragraph 3. Okay, tingnan nyo po mabuti ha. Susulat ko to. This is exactly what I was telling you previously. 1, paragraph 3. 2, paragraph 4. Nakikita niyo yung trend? Ibig sabihin po, they appear in order. Ha? Sa paragraph 3, sorry, sa number 3, nag-skip ako kasi I spent more than 2 minutes na dun sa item. So, meaning, it will just drag my time further. I need to get more clues later. So, save ko na lang si 3. Skip ako kay 3. So, ulit, I got the answer from paragraph number 3 for question 1. On the next paragraph, that's where I got the answer for paragraph 2. So I am seeing quite a trend here. I skip item number 3 just because, again ha, wala po muna akong answer. Hindi po not given ang sagot ko muna. Skip lang po muna. No? And number 4, David Levy, being an amateur astronomer, was not taken seriously. And the answer here is in paragraph 5. The answer is no. Hindi siya, hindi sineryoso. He was actually taken seriously and he was given help by the scientific community after his discovery. So, what trend are we seeing? In number 1, the answer is in paragraph 3. In number 2, the answer is in paragraph 4. In number 3, I skipped it. In number 4, the answer is in paragraph 5. So are you guys seeing the trend somehow? Kasi ganito lang pong kasimple yan. The answers appear in order. They appear in order. Meaning, if you skip item number 3, meaning you don't have an answer for number 3 yet, And you saw that the trend is 1, paragraph 3, 2, paragraph 4, 3, I skip, 4, paragraph 5. They happen in sequence. So there's a clue that I want you to understand. That if you cannot find your answer for number 3 between paragraph 4 and paragraph 5, the answer is not given. Ulit, this is a very important discovery. I want you guys to understand. So I taught you several techniques how to make your life easier when it comes to the reading test. In some reading sets, your true, false, not given, yes, no, not given, appear in order. And now that we notice the trend, paragraph 3, paragraph 4, then you skip, then paragraph 5 on the next item, this confirms our trend. Totoo nga, may trend. They appear in sequence. The problem is, there's no answer for item number 3 yet. Because, 1, I consider it difficult. Number 2, Sir Kevin said that if I'm going to take more than 2 minutes for one item, it's better for me to skip it. It's better for me to skip it than to compromise the other items, which I may already acquire for this span of time I will be wasting for this item. And when you confirm that there's a trend, return to paragraph 4 and 5. Wala kang nakita na immensely undertaking yung project. The answer is not given. As easy as that. Hindi mo makikita yung sagot sa 3 sa paragraph 8. Although there will be some hints na pwedeng may similar words, it's just a coincidence. If they appear in order and you skipped an item, return to it, check your confirm your findings. And once you do, between paragraph 4 and 5, there's no mention of it at all. It simply means that you should give up and write the answer as not given already for that. Clear? Okay. Laga po yan, ha? Yun. Masimang. And that is the end of our discussion for today. Do you have any questions, Tipa? None. So once again, the replay of this discussion will be uploaded on my channel. Everything that, again, from slide 1 to slide 52, this is already converted into a PDF file. So for those of you who don't, who are not able to attend live lectures in the branch, I recommend that you tune in to ating Zoom meeting, like what 3 or 4 of our candidates did. And if you cannot attend the live lessons, either Zoom and discussion here in the branch, you can also check the replay, which will be at 1 p.m. So that is your reading major discussion. Once again, doesn't stop here. Have to apply every information you pick up today with your practices, and the best practice is none other than the mock exam, which is held every Tuesday and either Thursday or Friday. Magiging Thursday po siya kung meron po tayo actual exam. Sabi syempre, unahin namin sila kaysa pa. So dyan. Alright? Pwede po 2 times ka mag-appear na both morning and afternoon session are available. So, si Tuesday, you can appear here personally. Kung hindi naman kaya, meron din tayong alternative lesson posted dun sa ating channels. So, para sa academic, at para sa mga minor lessons, tulad kanina, vocabulary 1 was mentioned as the most important minor lecture correlated before the reading test. So as I've mentioned previously, there was one particular student who mentioned that naka 5.5 siya despite attending the major lecture despite practicing, and after attending Vocab 1, finally he was able to understand. Nakakuha na siya ng 8 consistently and 8.5 pang score niya sa reading test. Again, ha, we do reading major often. Before, we are only instructed to do this at least once a month. But I'm doing this 2 times a month, no? Because I am seeing a negative trend when it comes to the reading practices, reading sets of the students. Ang daming naka-8 sa speaking, naka-7.5 even sa writing. Those are very impressive feats already. You don't have to undermine. You don't have to think of this as not a good achievement on its own. This is actually a very wonderful achievement already. But getting 5.5 in reading is something that you could improve. I know you could do that through practice. That's why the branch is open. The testing center is open. You can make yourself familiar. Again, hindi ka nalalayo. Diba? Hindi ka pupunta ng Pampanga. Hindi ka nadadayo ng Tagaytay. Nadadayo ng Batit. Kailangan pa magtagupan ng Pampanga ng students. Hindi na alam saan sila pupunta. So ito lang. Dito lang po mismo. Kung saan ka nagmamak, saan ka nang mag-iignan. Tapos, hindi mo yung mga taga-bantay kami din. Kasi mga speaking examiners namin, kaya dami kumapasa ngayon sa speaking. Kasi handpick namin yung examiner. Kaya meron kami examiner na alam namin, baka magbigay. Ah, who was your examiner, Akash? Do you still remember? Was it a Filipina or foreigner? Foreigner examiner gives better score. Filipinos are even, right? They have that mentality. They don't want to see their own fellow Filipino going wrong. Nababasakit ah, kahit masyado ka lang. Dito lang tayo lahat, maghirap tayo lahat dito. With us experience the road in Aliaga. It's all experience the traffic and corruption. Walang halin. Pag foreigner, especially female examiners, even male examiners, and you're a female candidate, kasi ang hilig-hilig talaga ng mga Brits, the exotic Filipino beauty. Kaya kung naka 5.5 ka lang sa akin, sa coaching, maka 7.5 ka sa exam. Okay? Just because you're a Filipina, yun naman ang advantage. Exotic. Don't forget the exotic. Huh? So, questions po. Wala na? Ito no. Who among you guys made their writing practices? Okay. At si ma'am lang mag-i-exam, ano? Bukas. Good luck natin si ma'am. Good luck. Ayun lang, mag-siwi na kayo. Sa mga nasa Zoom, thank you. Kai. Aris and Redlin, have a nice day. God bless and good luck. Bye-bye.